most powerful brand building medium for marketeers, is it? Well, it is a brain-racking topic, and this is our first panel of the day. And ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the session chair, Mr. Saad Khan, National Planning Director, Strategic Planning, FCB Ulka, followed by our panel members with a round of applause, Mr. Ajay Dung, Joint Executive President and Head Marketing, UltraTech Cement, Avinash Kumar, AVP Marketing, Patanjali. Keep the applause flowing. Rajiv, Dubey, Head of Media, Dabur, Sumit, Mathur, Director Marketing, Kellogg, India, and Vivek, Sharma, Chief Marketing Officer, Pidilite. Topic B, is TV still the most powerful brand building medium for marketeers? You may tweet about this
So
as
good
well.
Afternoon, people. And I think you asked the right question. Is TV still the most powerful medium for building brands in this country? And I was waiting to hear some responses, and I did not get those responses, okay? Except for one or two, maybe like really people who believe in that. So I'm still asking the question once again. Is TV still the most powerful brand building medium in this country? Okay. So fine, so what we're going to do is we're going to start on this, okay? The topic says TV first somewhere. Now, to be very honest, okay, I've got like a panel of some really big marketing stalwarts with me, okay? And we have been discussing before this session, okay? We had like a little coffee together. And so is there a correct answer for that? Is there a right answer for that? Or is answer slightly complex and it has many variables? And that's what we're going to discuss. So I'm Saad Khan, I am National Planning Director at FCB Ulka. Okay, I'm just gonna introduce the panel to you again. Okay, so we got Sumit from Kellogg's. Okay, we got Rajiv from Dabur. We got Vivek from Pidilite. Okay, we got Avinash from Patanjali. And we got Ajay from UltraTech Cement. Okay, so I just set this whole thing up for a while. Okay, I'm not a media planner, guys, by the way, so just be, it's for me as well, this is like a good learning experience because I'm going to only learn from these gentlemen out here, okay, very clearly. But I have certain questions because what I have been seeing is how media landscape is changing, okay, over the last few years, okay, constantly. So I was brought up in a generation where we only had television and print, okay. Today we have digital, today we have OTT, today we have so many new things, augmented reality, all these kind of things and mediums are coming up big time. Okay, and things are changing in a very, very big way, okay? Nothing is small in this country, as I always believe that, because we are a huge country, you know, everything is under-penetrated from that point of view, right from categories to mediums and everything. Okay, digital is touching 300 million people plus, okay, TV is 800 million people plus, okay, and so is like print is going into millions of households. So what is happening, and I will just like come to the panel now, is that in this whole new complex scenario, earlier planning media and going out and talking to consumer probably was an easier job, okay? But now with all the fragmentation, one within the mediums, and also the availability of multiple mediums, okay? When you guys think of your marketing plans, when you guys think of the role, okay, of each medium, okay, how do you define the role, say, of a television, the role of a digital, or say, the role of a print, okay, really, and that's the thing. How do you manage the marketing mix, the media mix that you have out there, okay, and that's what, and I think anybody, I would probably want to start with, Sumit, with you, if you can just go ahead on this.
No, it's a million-dollar question. I think that's what media planning agencies have been doing for a very long time. So in my mind, guy. It's not as complex, honestly. Ultimately, the task for us to grow our businesses is what's our source of growth, where they are, and how do we reach them in the most cost-effective way, right? I mean, at a very simple, basic level, that's what it is. I'm a firm believer on reach and just delivering reach, more reach, in the most cost-effective way, every month, every day, every week. So that's the principle with which I come. Now, to deliver this reach, which is the medium that then ensures that I can do it in the kind of budget we have, different brands, different organizations will be in different life stages. And therefore, somebody would need a pan-India reach that they'll want to do. Somebody might be a Bombay specific brand, somebody might be a tier two brand, and so on and so forth. So what works for that, right? I think that's important. So with that as a context, I think coming specifically to the point on TV, and I think if I have to put the moves on the table, it's about TV versus digital, right? Every other medium is there, has always been there. And my point of view, honestly, is that if you think about from a pan-India scale point of view, what we have done in the past has been clearly television. I don't think it's going to go away in any time soon. It will remain for the first, in our terms, for the first 35% at 3+. TV will always be the medium that gives you the right ROI, the right reach as well. Of course, TV comes with spillovers, etc. And that's the challenge. And I think that's the role where I believe a lot of good brand managers or good category heads or good marketeers, that's the place where they make the difference, which is about how do you then, as you top that reach, how do you become more and more cost effective? Digital plays a brilliant role, for example, on doing that. Of course, you have the challenges of whether it's unduplicated reach and so on and so forth. You know, we can have multiple of those conversations. But if you just step back and think, you know the kind of impressions digital delivers today versus what it used to deliver a couple of years back. So you will get incremental reach from that. The point to keep in mind, therefore, is that how do you play the mix to your benefit, to the geography that you are in, and to the life stage your brand is in? I think simply put, that is what my guidance to my team has always been. And more often than not, I've seen that work for our benefit.
Going by what you're saying, there are a few things that we need to consider. I'm not a great fan of the TV advertising, though we spend quite a bit of it. And what I have understood is if you ask yourself how you view your television, whenever there is an ad break, you change your channel. So how do I know whether when I am shooting at the right person and it is hitting the right person? See, the whole game is about 780 million people reachable by TV channels. Who are these 780 million people? Nobody knows in first place. Second place, the world has changed, especially when you have 550 million people on high-speed internet, courtesy, Jio, and the market, the way it has changed. At least I know if I have reached 50 million people, if I have reached 70 million people, if I have reached 100 million people, at least I know who I am interacting with. Second thing, since, things are changing. TV is no more an idiot box. It is getting more and more intelligent. It is getting more and more interactive. There is no doubt when you are going for a national campaign and you are going for brand building, you have to bombard through TV. Because that is one medium where there is no control, nobody has no control. So you will be seen all over the places. But how many people are receptive and how they are going to respond or rather embrace your brand is something which is going to be challenging. Third thing that is going to be, whatever has happened from tomorrow, the world is going to change. Because tomorrow is 1st February, and then you have a new TRAI guideline coming into place. So the idea is, and now if you look at other thing that I'm going to share with is, that there are more than 50 million smart TVs going to be operational by 2020. So these are, when the programs are interactive and it is more and more, according to my test, I'll go to that channel. Another thing that needs to be considered is that when you are talking about TV, TV is not into a prime time. People talk about prime time when we are buying TV. So 7 o'clock, 6 o'clock to 11 o'clock is your prime time. But what is actual prime time is 8 to 10. So in the new world, my time is going to be prime time. It is not the time slot that you are getting people into. And that is how, when I look at my media planning, I get into it. Thank you.
Yeah. So Viveka, you want to talk about this a bit because we have a very strong view on digital side as well, okay, which is a very good thing. But we were chatting about the roles, okay, today.
Thank you.
You can use any of this.
See, TV is a powerful medium and it will remain as powerful as you would use it. The way we use TV as marketeers will have to change. So the debate is not so much about, is it the most powerful medium? The debate perhaps is around, how is it going to remain the most powerful? Now, let's keep few things aside. TV will give, as he rightly said, will give the highest reach. In India, if you want to build, we were discussing it over coffee, if you want to build a scale brand, if you want to build a brand beyond 1,000 crores, 2,000 crores, there's no gainsaying the fact that you have to use television. But certain things are happening because of which the role of TV is going to change. First of all, there are other mediums which are encroaching into the TV viewing habits. That's one thing which is happening. And what we call distracted TV viewing is reality of the day. Second thing is that the sole TV viewing is actually only is around 40%. Rest is all combined family viewing. Because 98% of households are still single TV households. You know, the reality of mass scale brands in India is that the reality is not here, the reality is not in the TV studio, reality is somewhere outside. And that reality is that single TV households we have. But having said that, even youth living in class 3, class 4 towns are digitally active and digitally savvy, they are on internet. So the way we would use TV and the way role of TV has to change, I'll illustrate that with an example. TV is not going to be a medium which is a medium we're going to use primarily to put the brand message, which is pray and then see the task is done. If I take Dr. Fixit, now Dr. Fixit is a waterproofing brand. 10 years ago, I could have just put my message on TV and said, now awareness will happen, people will ask about the brand, my brand is built, I have done distribution. But no longer. What the role TV is playing is that now we're using multiple mediums. So what we do is that we are the same brand ambassador, Amitabh Bachchan. The message on TV is to create a need in the mind of consumer about waterproofing. That's one message. We then give that message to everyone. Now what happens is, this person, if he's in the cycle of making a house or waterproofing, then he comes to us through a call center, digital, or we do digital marketing separately and we generate a lead, and then we use digital medium to give him a different message. And the message is about, if you don't do waterproofing, then there's a consequence of price or your house will be leaking, etc., etc. Then we use different medium, which is the third medium, which is direct contact. He comes to us and we give him a different message. The point I'm trying to illustrate is the way we use TV is going to change drastically. And TV is nowadays, for some brand, it's the only medium for actually giving the message. But there are two, three things which are happening. One is that TV has a halo effect on the impact of other medium, which is digital. And that is what we speak about, whether it is paid or social. You know, it's a fact. There is a report by Accenture which shows that the ROI, which is what actually affects marketeers and business people the most, the ROI of TV is the highest, followed by paid search. And it is also a fact that paid search get positively affected by television advertising. So television advertising, you can't walk away from it. Otherwise, the likes of Flipkart and Amazon would not be using TV to build their brand, given the digital mediums. We have observed that when we advertise on television, the searches we have, branded searches, go up dramatically. My call to call centers grows up dramatically. That's one impact which TV is having on digital, which we have to take cognizant of. Second thing is, long term, if you want to build brands which are emotional, which have a long-term consideration, I don't think you can build brands like Dove or Fevicol or Bajaj only through digital, because digital is also a medium which is, it's a bipolar, or it's a medium with paradoxes. On one hand, it's a medium which has very low attention spans. You flip, with the flip of a finger you go. On other hand, the subject which interests you, whether it's a cause, CSR, water shortage, or child issue, or something else, you're involved. You watch that video, you forward it, you share it. So it's a medium with both impact. So the point is that the TV has to be used in conjunction with this, these mediums in a complementary fashion. And as you said, sir, very, very well, the content is going to matter really, really well. The only second point I'm making is that if TV will play and continue to play a very, very big role in driving brands in the minds of people, which is the primary role actually, which is consideration. I don't think we could have built Madhya Pradesh or Vodafone or Kerala tourism without TV advertising. Only through digital, not possible. But yes, digital can complement when you get a person in the funnel by making sure that as a marketer, you take him down the funnel and take him to the logical conclusion of closing the sales. So rest we can add and discuss more.
Yes, and Rajiv, what's your view on this?
I'll just tell you a small story about one research we did in city of Banaras, Varanasi, in UP. So our research team went to a small village and researching one farm labor, a woman, and asked her, do you watch TV? She said, TV dekhne ka to time nahi milta hai, but kya fir kaise dekhte ho? To ye phone hai hamare paas mein, isme ek lal button hai. Isko aise daba dete hain, to gaana bajna shuru ho jata hai. So she doesn't know anything about digital, YouTube, everything. She watches YouTube on this medium. Okay. Having said that, you know, this is one real life story which one has seen, and you can see, look around and see all your people who matter to you, people who basically buy your products, they are on digital and they are using it. Having said that, you know, no brand in our industry, in FMCG industry, can be built without television at the moment. But you know, what is television? Television is what? It's a bunch of programs. Why do people watch TV? It's because of the entertainment. So anything which can provide entertainment to people would be the screen to be on, whether it's through mobile or through the big screen, or coming through a TV channel, or coming through, say, a platform like YouTube or something, people will lap it up. Currently, the numbers are in favor of the broadcast medium, television, 826 million TV. Digital is still scattered. Measurability is a big question. People don't share data. Nobody is readily sharing. I mean, nobody shares the data. I mean, it's all shot in the dark. So unless until you experience it, you can't put money behind it. That's number one. Number two, there is no model which can tell you what is a sufficient amount of money to be put in order to build a brand. In TV, we have some empirical data for past 25 years or probably more, which we can say that, you know, you put so much of money and you do so much advertising and probably, you know, you can build a brand like that. That science right now doesn't exist. Third is ROI. You talk to any digital seller, guys will say we are very cheap. How? I don't know, because still I find my ROI on TV. And so for me, I'll continue to spend money on TV, but not ignore digital.
Ajay, you come from cement industry, okay, and which is highly commoditized as a product, okay, as a product. And therefore, the brand plays a very, very important role, okay, as far as cement is concerned. So how do you look at television?
Okay. So bad day for me because two things. I had earlier avatar, I was in media and FMCG and all that stuff, and HT, one of the key programs that we promoted, big activation, was a no TV day. And sad day that I'd be, I think, pointing to, differing with some of my colleagues here, friends here. Second bad day, because you called my category commodity, a bad place for me. And so I think going away. But I think I'm a big believer in the what they call the Byron Sharp School of Management. So I think this targeting, while digital is the new shiny thing, it's hugely, this new shiny object is hugely overestimated in my this thing. One, me watching advertising within the set of a certain frame and page, etc., ask ourselves, does it play a huge role in terms of how we react to the brand? I don't believe so. So I think, is it changing the landscape? Certainly so. I think we had just one knife in the kitchen. Now we have a paring knife, we have a scaling knife, etc., etc. But coming to the core question of, has TV effectiveness gone down? Let's look at numbers kind of stuff. Has reach gone down? I don't think so. Has time on TV gone down? It is going up. Is the video, even on digital, the video content that is going up? So to me, whether you watched it on the idiot box or you watched it on the mobile phone, I don't care. It's for, I think, the TV channels to look at. Third thing, if you look at if reach and frequency are the two things that you go by the that school of thought, there's nothing that substitutes that kind of stuff. Globally also, while there is huge hue and cry, I think over the last 10 years, despite huge amount of stuff moving to digital, the share of revenue has come down, I think 4 to 5% off TV kind of stuff, despite digital growing wherever it is growing. Viewership share is about 50-55% on TV even now. Has you watch, and in defense of TV, I said irony now, but in defense of TV, completion rates are 100%. You watch an ad on same parameters that you evaluate the other shiny object, 100% completion rates. I am not thumb flicking TV at that point of time. The ad break versus content viewership rates down 20%. Has that changed in the last 30 years? I don't think so. Anita, tell me if those numbers are correct, incorrect. Do you have another tool which you need to use fairly strategically? So UltraTech we use. We cannot teach consumers how to build their homes or give them expert advice on how to build their homes or simple checklist how to build homes. That task we do through digital. But from a brand building point of view, has TV's effectiveness gone down? Or is this medium any less effective? I don't think so, right?
Lovely.
Since we're talking about effectiveness, I think just want to make a comment here. What is effectiveness of TV? Is it just reach? Is this reaching X number of people? Because there's a lot of distracted viewing there. Or is brand awareness enough? If you think, take two categories, Dr. Fixit. Is it enough to reach 100 million people and get them aware about the brand? Is it about reaching people, those 10 million only out of this 100 million, who are making homes? So how do I reach them? So perhaps effectiveness has, TV will have to get down to sharper mechanisms or complement with other mediums to define effectiveness as, am I reaching my audience at the time when he's in the cycle of thinking about my category of the product? And that is going to be the name of the game. So yes, through digital, I can target people and I can reach only those 1 million who are right now in the process of making homes. But in TV, that's not possible. There's no way for me to target. I have to still spray and pray. That's one. But having said that, digital also has a limitation. How much of wide reach digital can get? Very, very. Despite all the high numbers of penetration on mobile and on phone, the advertising reach of digital is still very, very limited. That's a fact. So we have to look at effectiveness from the point of view of not only reach, but reaching my person, consumer at the time when he's in cycle of buying. I think that something which other mediums will complement TV greatly. So that has thought of.
I would give you two data points and then elaborate on it. I had a discussion around a year back that despite digital being so prevalent in America, the share of digital versus TV is almost similar. It has not gone down. But when this was spoken at after that, the kind of transformation which has happened, which is being ignored, is that OTT platform has come into play, one. Second, if you ask me, I don't have a TV connection anymore at my home. I have a TV with Chromecast, and what I do, I have all the apps of all broadcasters on my mobile phone, and I'm a premium customer of all of them. And if I add value of the entire thing and the time, kind of content and the kind of freedom that I have, there is no denying, nobody is saying that TV is going to go down. TV is certainly going to yield space to digital in first place. Second, See, in India especially, the adoption speed is pretty slow. If you look at any of us, all of us have been brought up on TV. So there is a resistance to change. People don't understand digital so fast, and so they are not trained into that medium. So what they try to do is push it and put it at an arm's length. It is a shiny thing for sure, and it will keep on shining. It will certainly have an impact on shininess of TV. When TV came into picture, if you remember 1982, when first colored broadcast happened, and the kind of TVs that we used to watch and you see today. See, when I'm talking to a customer, I want at least a grip on the data that I am getting into. That data is not at all available. It is not that I'm going to do a zero budget on TV. I'm going to have at least 45-50% of my budget on TV for sure. But my expense on the digital space is going to increase, and that I'm not increasing my budget at all. What I am doing weaning away few rupees from that to this. And digital in itself, what you said is correct, that when you have a TV campaign going and a digital campaign going, then you have to have an integrated marketing plan. TV needs to be supported by digital. If you don't have a support of digital, your TV plan is not going to work anymore. And the times have changed. You have such an interactive medium. He said red button. If you ask me, I don't use TV at all for watching music. I simply stream it. And I believe with the kind of tariff plan that is there and the kind of interactive medium that TV has become, or rather digital has made TV an interactive medium, it is going to change, and it is going to change drastically. So whether you like it or not, in year, especially in next 1 year at least, things are going to move. I had a plan shared by Middle East Group M, because we were trying to expand into that market, and they showed us that in last 1 year, TV has come from 52% to 43%, and digital has also reached 43%. Print is still there. Nobody is talking about that, but print is activation thing. So call for action happens through print still. And in India, it is going to remain so. Despite digital being in space, TV being in space, the number of the circulation of newspaper has increased. So nobody is going to eat anything completely, but data and the money and budgets are going to shift for sure.
Just one quick point. One of the things that's honestly held me in this conundrum has been if we have our consumer journeys really thought through, this automatically gets solved. So, if you're looking at driving awareness, driving wide persuasion, TV will play a role. But if you're looking at driving advocacy, TV can't do anything, right? So Instagram will work brilliantly for you. Twitter will work brilliantly for you. So I think as marketeers, it's important that we do our homework. The brand's role in a consumer's life is certainly not just seeing a TV ad. He will engage with the brand at very different levels, just like he engages with each of the mediums at very different levels. So it's important that we understand that. We clearly identify what's the objective at various points. Equally, for example, in-store, when he's going and sitting in the aisle, he's probably looking for value more than anything. So your message changes there as well. So how do you ensure that you are first clear on what the role of your brand from the time a consumer is aware of the category to the time he's standing in an aisle and buying you is clear? And mind you, this is not linear, right? It's happening at multiple levels. So if that's clear to you, then you can define the role of the medium, and then you can use each medium to the best possible way.
So let me just add to what Sumit said. So there's no denying the fact that we need TV to have large reach and to build scalable brands. One is that mapping the consumer journeys, and as I said, for Fixit also, you reach consumer journeys at different points in the journeys and use TV for something else, digital for something else. But there's something else which is happening nowadays. A lot of consumers and young consumers believe brands less, and they believe the word of mouth and influencers more. There are YouTube celebrities, there are Instagram celebrities. So brands will have to use TV to do general awareness and brand building, so that brands in consideration set. But to get them to move from consideration to preference and purchase, you'll have to use other mediums notably digital, to drive influencer marketing. Influencer marketing is a word of mouth for whether it is health, nutrition, or fashion. That is the categories where, or in our categories, in construction, and Ajay will abide by it, influencers play a very strong role, your contractor, your builder, so you will believe them more. So when experts speak about your brand, then people believe your brand and then they make the purchase, and that is something TV cannot do. So yes, all are required. I think as a marketeers, as we go into the future, TV will remain the largest and the most powerful medium, and I want to stick to it. But the way we put assign objectives to TV versus other mediums will have to be more granular, because other mediums will emerge, differential tasks have to be assigned, consumer journeys have to be mapped, then only TV can be made more effective. It's often a fallacy, I must say, we do by comparing ourselves to US and we do extrapolation. The issue is, when will we reach there, how fast will we reach there, and will we reach there in the same shape? You know, Rama Bijapurka in the book very, very notably said, India is today a duckling. Will it grow into a swan? No, it will grow into an ugly duckling. It will be different shape. So our digital landscape 10 years from now will be different from the US is. That's my thing. And I think we'll have to evolve our own models, because India is no longer a triangle. It's a rhombus. There'll be a fat middle, there'll be a small at the bottom, small on the top. And each will require different ways in which we'll use TVs with them. TV for affluent medium will be different. For middle will be different, for bottom will be different. So we'll have to learn to be very, very versatile and use TV not in a spray gun approach, but different approach is what I'm going to say.
Yeah, I agree with you there. You know, with TV, you know, when we think of TV, we think of 800 channels and, you know, and 24/7 kind of targeting of ads to people. But the moment you start focusing on a fewer time bands, on a fewer channels, then, you know, your scores change. And that's what we have done in recent past. We have looked at fewer channels, fewer time bands, fewer genres, left out a few genres completely, and seen some success on television. On digital, a digital ecosystem can be divided into three parts. One is basically search and display, second is e-commerce, and third is a video part. So one has to spend money judiciously in these three parts. We have seen very high rate of success in the e-commerce part of it, where you know, you put your ad right next to the purchase basket and you see a very good result. As far as the video part is concerned, the success rate is still yet to be felt. What is the success rate there? Because probably there is the question of sufficiency is not answered so far, in that sufficiency and viewability, these two things are not answered. And one general observation that, you know, whenever you're watching something on YouTube, your eyes are on the skip button, you know, you're just looking at the skip button and skip, and then you start watching. So that's another thing which is yet to be answered. Although there is a huge, the numbers are huge right now, it can't be ignored. One thing which we have not talked about here today is print, you know. Bichara print, uske baare mein koi sochta hi nahi hai. That also is very important, you know. I quote this example all the time. When Google had to launch its phone, they took Economic Times front page. Google spent about 1100 crores rupees last year in television, print and stuff. They had their own medium to spend money as well. They chose television and print and others as well. So that says a lot about what we have to offer today, which is the television, the print, and the rest of it.
Correct, I agree. And the best thing was I always wondered all these brands which have digital at their core, okay, like they are digital fundamentalists, right? Okay, Amazon, Google, even they had to come on television, okay. And that's something, okay, which says a lot about, still about the strength of the medium. But one very interesting thing, Rajiv, you said, okay, and I kind of caught on to it was, okay, that no brand can be built without television in India. Okay, and I just want to like spend a bit of time on this. Okay, see, so before television, before 82, at least in this country, okay, brands were still being built. Okay, they were being built on print, okay, and magazines. Then television came in, and again brands took on television. Okay, then digital came in, and again now we have very, very strong opinions. Okay, like some guys really believe that digital is what really works. Okay, and there are guys who are saying keep a balance. There are still guys who are saying no, nothing beats television. Okay, question which I really have here is, okay, to build brands, okay, do we really need, say, a television or those kind of things, okay, those big scale mediums? There are many brands in the world which have done this, few, by the way, okay, but we have, which have done this without really going out, okay. Red Bull, I always kind of like think, okay, how could they build a brand, okay, and they actually spend a very, very paltry amount on television, okay. Zara, okay, again, 0.3% of their entire marketing spend is on mainline media. Now, how do these brands have become big? Okay,
Bira.
So, how these brands? Okay, something they are doing. Okay, they are not probably approaching it in the classical way. Maybe I'm not sure, but there's something that they're doing, and they're still building themselves without really getting on, say, big reach. Okay, kind of mediums.
I think, you know, the product idea itself was very big. You know, so initial days of iPhone launch, the first year of iPhone. When it became Jesus Christ of phones. Yeah, did they advertise? I don't think so. It was only through influencers and word of mouth and stuff.
And sorry
same,
to cut you.
Same goes for all these brands, because you know, the product itself was so good that it went on its own. The kind of category I was talking about is FMCG category, where we operate in, and there's a huge competition.
Okay.
And everybody's trying to gain 0.1% market share. So there, you know, it's very important to be on television, and you have to spray your advertising to a lot of people. And at some level, I think a little bit of spillover works very well for our kind of business.
Yeah. So then I will go to what Vivek was saying. Actually, Vivek made a very interesting point that, you know, about scale. Okay. And that's the key thing maybe somewhere. Like even in, say, juices, okay, beverages, okay, we got a brand called Paperboat, okay. Of course, it's no comparison to, say, a Dabur Real or a Tropicana in terms of volumes and everything. But point is that Paperboat still has built itself without really, if I recall correctly, going hardcore on, say, television, okay. Is it that, is the only thing is that TV helps you scale up? Is that what somewhere we can, like...
No, Saad, I think you asked an interesting question, but often I think we need to take a step back and ask a more fundamental question. The question is, for whom am I building this brand and at what scale I want? If I'm building a brand from 18 to 22, and if my ambition is to reach only X million people, fine. For every thing we say, there are going to be exceptions, there are going to be aberrations. Fab India is a mass brand. Fab India is now, I don't know, 600, 800 crore brand, built without advertising. TV, they are in print, they are not on TV. So, yes, you can build a brand. You can build a scale brand also. Now, it depends who your TG is, where this TG is. You know, these answers are not so simplistic, saying, I can build a brand without TV, with TV. So, it depends on your ambition. And, you know, Rajiv, you have a fantastic example. Apple iPhone was not advertised, was built into an iconic niche brand till some time back they came on television, right? Why did they come on television? Why they're on billboards now? Because they want to achieve scale. How do you achieve scale in India? You need television.
Yeah.
The point is that, yes, there are two aspects to using TV in India for building brand. One is scale, what your ambition is, where your target group and audience is. And the third thing I still say is that if you want to build sustainable emotional engagement with audience, which is more wide, not youth, there are always exceptions to what I'm going to say. I'm going to get hit by any one of them. I think you need television. And so, for example, other aspect we should look at is, you know, what is TV? TV is a screen size or TV is content? Today, the housewife is watching, let's say, Kumkum Bhagya on television. Earlier, she had to do appointment viewing. Today, she can actually stream and watch it at any point she wants, on the television, on the same screen. So what is TV? TV is going to evolve into what? It will be a very curious mix of content, screen size, but there are exceptions here also. See, there are certain things which people would want to watch on big TV, big screen TV, which is live sports events, okay, big movies. Now, would they like to watch their big movie on a phone? I doubt it. So TV will play a role, content will evolve, TV will also become smart. Now TV, now OTTs, which you must have spoken of in the morning, is going that way.
Yeah.
We will have to become smarter to see how do we integrate a brand message into OTTs without getting intrusive. Those issues will come into play, and I think we'll have to evolve a different model of balance of privacy and intrusion to make sure that we use the TV in the right way, because TV is no longer going to be beaming. TV is also going to be, I want TV at the time I want, where I want, if I'm streaming.
Sumita, just like one thing for you, we were discussing that about, okay, so of course, TV, because of the whole cost factor of TV, okay, because the cost of, not the cost per reach, okay, actually the entry cost, okay, you have to take into account share of voice, you have to take into account, okay, okay, is it really enough? There's a threshold always, okay, on television, and sometimes you think, okay, if I don't have this much of budget, for example, where I can beat, say, other guys, okay, then what is the kind of call you will take that point in time? Will you still go over there probably and not achieve, okay, what you set out to do, or will you deploy that budget, okay, into something else which will help you achieve it?
No, I think I'm a very strong believer that a basic threshold is important, and below that it won't work for you. And therefore, I guess if you are not being able to reach the threshold, it means you probably are neither not a pan-India brand, in which case there are other ways in which you will do it, right? So whether it's regional TV itself or it's about digital, if you're doing metros, you can do that as well, print. So all those choices are always there. But yes, a basic reach is important. Therefore, a basic investment is important on television. It does result in spillovers, but more pros than cons, and nothing is perfect in that sense. And therefore, in media parlance, a 30% to 35% at 3+, unless and until you are being able to deliver that, you are not reaching that. Also, remember that whatever market mix modeling that we have done, we have seen that that level of reach is the highest ROI that you can get on television. So the versus all other mediums put together. So the first amount of money that goes, if you're being able to deliver that kind of reach, you'll get really high ROIs, and then of course all of it starts tapering and you can put other mediums. But the short answer to your question is that you have obviously have to make that choice. You need to have that much investments available so that you can put a basic reach behind your plans.
Yeah, correct. Because the reason I ask is not every brand, okay, is the leader brand. Not every brand is a big brand. You will have always have more challengers, and they will have lesser budgets. And how smartly will they play the whole media game, okay, instead of fighting, say, 3 times, 4 times the money which, say, the leader is putting on television. And that
no, absolutely. You can be much more guerrilla about doing your thing. So if you're Bombay, you can... I'm saying YouTube can give you really good reach, even if I leave the entire conversations around how many people are watching it and what's the click-through. But it does... can give you the kind of awareness you want in metros and even outside metros for that matter. So clearly possible.
Rajiv, you want to say something?
So just to add to this point, you know, you're talking about entry cost. So entry cost could be different for different people. So if you suppose if you have a restaurant which is operating in a basically trying to attract customers in a local neighborhood, you know, then obviously you'll not use television. You'll use probably a local newspaper, or maybe, you know, maybe digital will work in a way. But if you're talking about pan India brands, something which has a high distribution, then definitely TV is the answer. A small store, a small restaurant, a startup, or say something like a small thing like, you know, milk basket is what we have in Delhi right now. So basically, these guys, you can order your milk or anything which you want in the morning. At 11 o'clock at night and at 5 o'clock in the morning, you have it at the doorstep. So that's very localized kind of a startup. So those kind of things, obviously, you don't need television. You know, you would need something, word of mouth, influencers, and stuff.
I think someone also talking about content. I think you were talking about content before we came here. And somewhere I also believe that, you know, TV, okay, after a while, okay, gives you a sort of content fatigue, because ultimately, what do? We just create few copies, okay, one or two copies, and or 3 copies maybe, and we run it like for next 1 year or 6 months or whatever time. Versus say on digital, okay, you can do so much more, you can refresh it easier, okay, there can be more engagement, okay. So how do you solve for this? Because of a brand which is totally going, say, towards television, okay, or having a big chunk of the budget on television, how will it solve the whole content piece, okay, on this?
So, again, contrarian on that one, I think brand managers get bored of their copy far more than consumers. I am a firm believer that while I think we passionately love our brands, consumers are not waiting to see our ads and saying I've lapped it for the 80th time and now I don't want that kind of stuff. Second piece, I think if your insight on the brand is right, and that resonates with a large swath of audience, then that's the piece to go. Rather than personalizing for the 120th ad customized by saying, hey Ajay, do you want to buy this bottle of water? Just because my name is written on the ad, I'm not going to do that kind of stuff. So customer, I think some of those things, I think are good pitch points from some medium's point of view. But I think these two points are, I think, overplayed. And the second piece on this one is content. We are not, very frankly, if we being completely Jewish about it, we are buying eyeballs at the end of the day. Whether consumers are watching my ad within news or they're watching between Kyunki, if I've gotten the right audience, and like you said, you've scoped and spanned the zoom in lens of, if I'm Mercedes, obviously there's no point me going on kind of stuff, right? But if I've gotten my right audience, content variation actually plays a fairly low role in terms of where you've seen the commercial. If you've gotten the insight right, if you're connecting with the audience right, too much variation within creative, I'd rather step back. That is just activity that's like running in an airplane, right? You're just doing activity for the heck of it. And like I said, we get bored of our commercials far more than...
Yeah, so else. I'm... Yes, go on.
I just want to add to Ajay saying, see, that's not the issue, because how many of us have ever got bored of watching Fevicol ads on TV? We run the ads far less than what everyone thinks, but still have the highest share of mind, because if you create good engaging ad, medium is not an issue. But there's a contrarian example. We can think of famous Zuzu's ads. If you are still a very versatile marketer, you can still create content which need not bore people over 40 days. So it depends how you treat content. But I fully agree with Ajay. You know, content and boredom is not an issue of TV. Issues of relevance and engagement.
So when you are talking about all this, let me give you an example for the company that I work with. 5,000 crores without any advertisement on any of the entertainment channels, GEC. We were not on GEC. You are talking about Apple, which was celebrated all across the world. And this was a Patanjali brand, which was not known at all. And it is an Indian brand. 5,000 crores in no time without any advertisement on GEC. We were there only. I used to sell media to Baba Ramdev. And that is how I was hired. We used to do only print and news channels, which were, if you look at that time, none of the brands, FMCG brands, ever ventured into news genre on television. And still the brand was built. It is not the advertisement that builds your brand. The way you interact and the way people receive you, despite not having any information dissemination through mass medium, still the brands are made. But that does not discount either TV as a medium, or it does not highlight digital as a medium. Humne 4 saal to kuch nahi kiya digital pe. We reached 10,000.
But Ramdev is Apple for you, right?
Yeah. No,
exactly. Ramdev is iPhone.
No, and Ramdev is Apple for me, but I have an Apple in front of me also.
Question again is, like, if there was no Baba Ramdev over there, would have done the same thing, because there's already a big brand, okay, which...
It became a case study that news genres can also build a brand. And you will be surprised to know that it was not brand building exercise. Hamare paas paisa hi nahi tha. And news, if you ask people, what is the money frequency which is required on a GEC and versus news channel, the news channel was dirt cheap. That is why we went there. And it worked.
because it had to work, whether we are there on news channel or not on news channel, Patanjali would have been what it is today. It would not have changed anything.
You know what, yeah, actually, so basically what works is advertising, right? What works is advertising, whether it's on news channel or any other channel.
I think, see, also very important is because there's this, I can see that there's a decent amount of say, TV is important, and maybe decent amount of like digital also probably very, very important, okay? Apple did not advertise on television for a long time, like, apart from that like Super Bowl ad, okay, and then the PC versus Mac campaign which they ran for a while in the middle, okay, one ad. Okay, which again goes to show point, okay, which you were talking about, was that the message is also as important as the medium, okay, probably sometimes more important. They were also, by the way, were not on digital media for a long time. It's a strange kind of company which isolated itself, okay, and yet...
There is no definitive answer to what you're asking. It will vary from brand to brand, situation to situation, and how people lap it up. There are a few things, let me give you an example. Herbal is something which people were waiting for because they had seen results of how chemical is harming you. Dabur was there for, I'm sorry, Rajiv is there, but Dabur was there for such a long time. And the kind of scale that Patanjali achieved in 4-5 years, Dabur was there for a long time. What did we do? We actually are helping them also to grow because we created a market.
Cool. So I think and just like probably we have, how much time do we have? I think we are done on time now. We are over time, 5 minutes now. We can see because the topic is so interesting, we can keep on talking about it. I've got like some 6 more questions to like really like prod about here, but just maybe for some other day, some other session. But the important point is, you know, still probably the jury is out because ultimately just saying it in one breath, okay, that this is the most powerful medium actually has many caveats, okay? Where are you? What is your target? Okay, what are your scale ambitions and all those kind of things? Who are you targeting? Who's your segment? Okay, and you have to look at that statement maybe in that context, for example. Scale, completely agree. If you want to achieve scale in this country, you're on a big growth trajectory, there's no way you can do without, say, television because it's the fastest and the most cost-effective medium to reach the maximum number of people. Digital, again, I think we have a lot of passion for digital here too. Okay, and some other question again, I've always...
And news channels,
okay. But that's a strategy. A lot of people have said that to me as well. Just go frequency, go news channel, okay. Particularly, for example, elections are coming
and
in, for example.
As I started and Rajiv agreed on it, you cannot discount print medium in India at least for at least 5 more years.
Yeah. So I will just leave the house like open for questions, okay, and then we'll just probably call it a wrap after that. There's a gentleman back there.
Hi, my name is Abhinav Zaveri. I'm a digital media publisher and a journalist. My question is open to the panel. Now, 90% of the households in India are still single TV. And the nature of content on television is also family-oriented. But when it comes to digital, it's more of individual targeted, right? I mean, you cannot have shows like Mirzapur and Gandhi Bath on television because of the nature. Now, when it comes to brands, a brand like ITC Vivil, they're a big advertiser on television. But when it comes to digital, they tie up with a digital publisher and come up with a more targeted series which empowers women on women's rights. A brand like Durex Condom, I mean, Condom is a heavy advertiser on television, but when it comes to digital, they tie up with a news publisher to come out with a content on funny sexual encounters. So the question which I'm asking is, and it's open to the panel, do you think from a brand perspective, when you need more targeted and different category of advertising, like branded content, digital will be the way to go. And when you want to build a scale, TV will always be the undisputed leader. I mean, and that should close the debate. I don't know. I'm just asking.
So, brand, it's content which is very different, which is, if you've got to, most consumers in India are first-time homemakers. How to help you through that process, that's what Brand UltraTech does. So, it's... Right, horses for courses, what's the medium, what's it for you, what's the use? Sumit talked about is what part of the purchase decision making that you are tapping, what is the role that you've assigned? I think you've got to kind of play by the rules of the medium. There are just more tools available to you to achieve the task, to get the consumer right.
In a country like India, which is so hypocritical, what you're saying is not going to be correct. There are so many viewing habits that are there in public domain. You can go through those data, completely prohibited thing, but it is watched the most. You go to railway station where you have free Wi-Fi, and you just see what is happening on those places.
You have a question, sir?
Before that, the third objection, red flag of the day, hypocritical versus what, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, Rajiv said any good product can do well. So this is not just the question to Rajiv, but I would like to ask all the panelists. Is it only the product which is good can do well and can become a super brand from a brand?
Advertisers, advertising sinks bad products. So that we all know, right? The more you'll drive, I think the repeats negatively if you have great advertising and a bad product, you'll destroy it.
No, same. Yeah, I think bad products you can't sell beyond a point of time, right? Let's be clear. Whatever you do in advertising, your product has to be good. Now, advertising can help sell a proposition better, but of course, that's common sense. You'll know that.
And also, few of the brands like Red Bull or Bira, Zara, we have discussed. Most of these brands, yes, they are new. Zara, I'm not very sure. I don't have a recent number, but it is not very enterprising. When it comes to Bira and Red Bull, they get associated at the point of sale a lot. And therefore, I understand the numbers are improving. On top, the marketing and sales ops, they are very, very strong. And that's how it takes definitely some time, but it built. So not just advertising, yes, this forum is all about TV, whether TV or OTT, but I believe that it's closing the loop is very, very important when you communicate and you do not close. So what is the measure that we are taking to, get the end result? So communication is made, but at the end, many of time it does happen, which I have observed is, we are not able to actually either able to connect the right customer at the right time. So I just need to have little clarity from you all, if you can.
So can you simplify the question for us once more? I got lost a bit.
Yeah, so there were two parts of it. One was that the brands are even building without
mass media and
without advertising. But then again, as Vivek said, when Apple has to go to Mars, they have to use their television. So Bira still cannot be considered in terms of volume or revenue that they are still at that level. So all my question was that if product is good, advertisement is good, but still there are certain cases wherein still brand doesn't do well. Why is that?
So you're perfectly, I think that's the whole point we are trying to say. There's no one simple answer to this. If you have a great product, okay, you can also have a bad product. I completely agree. Don't sell it then, okay. You might have great advertising, and if it's great advertising on a bad product, it'll destroy the product faster. Okay, that's another issue. But then, of course, distribution. Okay, if you are in service, for example, okay, your experience on the ground. Okay, all those things have to work finally together. Okay, even the other things, like if you have more stakeholders. So Pidilite, definitely the way Pidilite works. Okay, with the whole carpenters, okay, with the everything, all those programs. Okay, the whole thing. Okay, and that is where the core of it is. That's where it gets its strength. So it's a mix. It's right, exactly the marketing mix, and it all has to work like a well-oiled machinery. Media is just one part of it. Talking to consumers, there's so much more. It's starting from the product, okay, to your distribution, to the way kind of sales people you have, okay, to the kind of okay, how you're talking out in there over there. And that's how it kind of like, it has to, it's orchestration in that sense of thing. And if any pillar is just kind of, any key is off, the melody is not going to sound good. That's, we know that.
Can I just add to this? Basically, every product has a product life cycle, right? And the fatigue sets in some, for some products very soon, very early, and for some products slightly later. In mobile phones, for example, you know, it's much sooner than, say, other products. It's like just a few months. Like look at Apple sales for this year. They have degrown for the first time in so many years. So you can't say that good product, good advertising, but still, you know, they're failing. Somewhere they're failing because probably the pricing is high or there's something wrong with the product. Or maybe somebody, competition is doing better products. So answer is not, it's not a one word or one sentence answer.
A very important thing we forget is access and distribution. You can have good product, you can have advertising, then of course Rajiv said pricing, but distribution determines success or failure in India. Whether a product is available at a place where consumer is going for that category. Remember that, that's the most critical. And the third, last but not the least, is sustaining that quality and access over a period of time. A lot of companies go like this and then sink. So sustaining your distribution, sustaining your quality over a period of time, and broad basing with various SKUs, is a very well-planned task. It is not easy.
You have to go back to your classroom on 4 P's. Let's take out the Kotler and read the 4 P's. All 4 need to be there in the right place.
Okay. Hi, this is Akshat from ICICI.
No, I'm sorry to interrupt. That would be our last question. We have 14 minutes over time.
Any question?
Last question.
Fair enough. So it seems that TV is not worried. My question is, why is it not worried when Avinash Kumar and me have stopped watching TV for last 2 years till the time Fire Stick came down? Why I stopped watching TV? Because there was nothing relevant which I could enjoy since the time Fire Stick came down on the OTT platform. I started watching it again and there's a lot of relevant content. It seems TV is not worried. Why is it?
TV is not?
TV medium, since morning it seems that TV medium is very confident about that nothing is going to go wrong with the TV medium and it will still reign supreme. It doesn't seem to be worried that there's a big change when Avinash Kumar from Patanjali says that he does not watch TV anymore and Akshat Tamu does not watch TV anymore.
So see, we can have, okay, the way I look at it always is finally when debates happen, I'll try to put numbers on the table because otherwise it becomes anecdotal, okay. Like I watch TV, like for example in this case, so we can say, okay, are these like 6 people out here, if I watch TV, okay, you still have like somewhat like 15% of people watching TV and maybe the 3 of us, people watch TV as well. So we don't know, but when you look at the numbers, by sheer numbers, when you put them on the table, okay, then nothing beats TV in that sense of thing. Second thing you have to always remember is, and I think the important point which I'm taking out from this session is, okay, that maybe you can do without TV. Maybe you can do without TV if you're a local player, if you're a regional player, okay, if your budgets are like, but if you're really aiming for the big kill, if you really want to grow out there, okay, in this country, because marketers will always have limited resources and you will have to deploy them in the best possible way, okay, to reach to your consumers. Also, what it does in terms of, again, a very, very important point was the emotional connection, the bonds that you want to create out there, okay? Storytelling, okay? So TV will still play a very, very important part, at least in that sense. When you have to scale up, when you have to go out, big ambitions, and you really have to, like, in a world where consumer is inundated with choices, has so many brands, okay, why should I? Building of the preference, the building of the consideration. Okay, those things work better probably, at least in my opinion, maybe on TV. When you're talking performance, you're talking all those other things, lead generations, maybe digital comes in very, very strong engagement, okay, as I say. Because understand one more thing on digital, what happens on digital, okay, and sorry, just like 30 seconds more, is that, see, TV still, when I'm sitting in front of TV, okay, I know that an ad will come, okay, it's not. But digital, when brands join digital, they're intrusive. Okay, because I want to talk to my friend. I don't want to see you come in. Okay, so we have a lot of debates happening in the world right now on this whole thing of intrusion. Okay, how much can you go branded? How much can you not go branded? That's why when we say, when brands go on digital, cut the branding down. Okay, cut it really down. Don't sell out there. People are not out there to buy stuff. They're out there to connect with other people. They're out there to like know more and learn or whatever they are doing. So yeah, so I think TV is still, if you have those ambitions.
Let me give you one more data, which is very contradicting. 90,000 people were surveyed about their TV viewing habits. All of them used to watch TV, and they were asked on what? On TV or on your mobile? 62% were on mobile. TV was on mobile was 62% out of that 90,000 people surveyed.
So I think we'll have to just cut us now. So, and if you just want, like, probably we'll be around for a while. Maybe just catch one of them if you just before we run out of here. Okay.
So thank you so much, gentlemen, and thank you for your questions. What an interesting session. We are 18 minutes overshot by time.